Hi, my name is Thibault and I'm a PhD student at Naval at Europe and Sorbonne University, and I'm going to introduce our work on analyzing the Colbert model. So this is a joint work with my supervisors, Stéphane Planchon and Benjamin Piewarski. And you can find the paper on archive. You can also find a complementary blog post on the Naval Labs Europe website. So we are interested in the ad hoc ranking task. And for this task, BERT-based model have been state of the art for about 2 years now. And a natural question is to understand why BERT works so well. And the thing is that we don't really know. Axiomatic or diagnostic approaches have been proposed. But in this work, we rather try to understand how contextualized matching models work. So over the last 2 years, the IR community introduced several BERT-based ranking models. But for our study, we decided to focus on Colbert. That actually offers an interesting trade-off between effectiveness and efficiency. And the model is actually simple. So you first encode the query and the document independently with BERT. And so you get a contextualized embedding for each subword. And then for each query subword, so each row in the figure, you seek for the highest cosine similarity in the document. So you get one score per row, and the final score is just a sum over the rows. And the model is also interesting for the analysis because the ranking score is a sum over probably words of some weights. So it looks like standard term-based models like TF-IDF. So before presenting our findings, I will first introduce the methodology as well as our motivation. So now we have defined the model, we are going to look at the distribution of scores for each query token over a pool of documents. So what does it mean exactly? So for each query, we have a set of approximately 1,000 documents retrieved by a first ranker. And for these documents, we analyzed how the model attributes scores for each token. So how is it done? Remember, the model assigns one score per document for each query token. So for instance, the purple squares on the first row in the figure. And so we collected the scores given by the model on our set of documents. And after that, we have a distribution of scores for each query token. And our goal is to check if these distributions have some different behavior depending on the term characteristics. And actually, we distinguish the exact and soft cases. So when we collect scores, we check if it comes from an exact match with the query token. So the model has assigned the maximum score to the exact same token in the document or a soft match. And in this case, the maximum score comes from a match with a different token. And so now we have two distributions of score per query term. Let's now check what it gives on an example. So here we have the query, what county is Dexter, Michigan in? And on the left, the exact match score distributions, and on the right, the soft case. And so we see that some terms that seem important in the query, they tend to focus on exact match. So here, county and Michigan. And their similarity scores tend to be higher with respect to other terms, and with respect to the soft case on the right. So their contribution in Colbert will tend to be higher. On the other hand, we have some terms that carry less content, so like is in the example. And these terms, they tend to focus more on soft matching. We can see that the exact and soft distribution in this case kind of look the same. And so our goal for this analysis was to summarize the previous observations on a set of test queries by looking at two aspects, term importance and exact and soft matching patterns. We also investigated how exact matching is promoted for important terms in Colbert. So we consider the MS Marco passage ranking task and a re-ranking setting. And we train our own Colbert model. And we also consider a non-fine-tuned model for the analysis. The last thing I want to mention is that BERT-based models, they operate at the subword level. And for the analysis, we kind of want to work at the word level. for which we have IR measures like IDF. So in the following, when a word is decomposed into subwords, we sum the contributions over the subwords. So let's first have a look at term importance. So term importance is a well-known heuristic in IR, and basically it tells us that some terms are more discriminative. So we checked if Colbert implicitly captures a notion of term importance, but we need to define such measure of importance for Colbert. And so what we propose is to check the contribution of a term in the ranking by comparing the original ranking to the ranking given when we drop the contribution of the term in Colbert. So now we have two rankings that we want to compare. And for that, we resort to AP correlation. Basically, it tells us that value close to one mean that the ranking are the same. And so the term is pretty much useless for the final decision. So we plotted the Colbert term importance against the standard term importance, which is IDF, by binning IDF values. And we observe a moderate correlation between the two, indicating that term importance is somewhat captured. And now if we turn our attention to matching patterns, so one of the main advantages of neural models is their ability to incorporate soft matches. But we know that exact matching is still a critical component of IR systems. So we inspected how Colbert deals with the two aspects, and particularly, we were interested if and how Colbert captures exact match. So back to our example, what we want to check is for each term, the difference between average scores in the exact and soft cases. So if the delta is higher, it tends to indicate that a term favors an exact match as the model learns to widen the gap in average between exact and soft scores for this term. So we plotted this measure against IDF, and we can again observe a moderate positive correlation. So it tells us roughly that terms with high IDF, so important terms, they tend to rely more on exact match. And the effect is already observable before fine-tuning, but is reinforced when the model is trained on relevance data. So we saw that Colbert can distinguish terms for which exact match is important. And we wanted to understand how the model is able to do this. And our hypothesis is that content words have contextualized embeddings that point to the same region in the space, while three-point words, so the word is in the example here, they have contextualized embeddings pointing to different directions. And so applied to Colbert, what does it mean? If for important terms, contextual embedding vary less, then Colbert will tend to select the same term in documents because the cosine similarity between the query token and the document will be close to one. And so how to check this? We conducted a spectral analysis of contextual term embeddings. So we first selected some terms, actually all the terms appearing in our query set, and we iterated over the collection and collected the contextual embeddings for these terms. Then we use an SVD decomposition on each matrix. So we have one matrix per term, and we check if there is a general direction by inspecting the ratio of the first eigenvalue over the sum. And we plotted this measure against IDF and got a confirmation of our intuition. Terms with high IDF tend to point in the same direction as the ratio increases with IDF. So to summarize our contribution, we proposed a new type of model analysis for BERT-based ranking models. And more precisely, we analyzed the Colbert model and showed that it indeed captures a notion of term importance. Exact match is still a key component of the model and is promoted for terms with high IDF. There are still some open questions, like are the above conclusions valid for other models or even for the first stage retrieval. Thank you for your attention and see you online at ICIA.